There was surprise as well as excitement when the Popemobile made its way through Bellahouston Park in Glasgow last September. Instead of the shy, stern Pope people had anticipated, there was a smiling figure seeking to understand rather than condemn. At the time, the visit seemed all the more successful because expectations had been low. But church leaders insist that there have been lasting benefits, including a renewed commitment among Roman Catholics to translate their faith into social action.
It's not as if Catholic social action has started because the Pope has come. We've always been deeply invested. But I think there's a new confidence that we want to let what we do be seen, let our voice be heard on the basis of the credibility of what we do. We have a great contribution to make, and there's more confidence in the Catholic community about making it.
The Pope's key message, his call for church and state to work together to create a better society, came just as the government was trying to work out how to do so, but in the light of deep financial cuts. The church now recognises the opportunity to re-enter a secular public arena, not just as the purveyor of moral values, but also with the added credibility of a major provider of social care. The Pope saw the big society as a big opportunity. Catholic commentators say his visit prompted a church previously marginalised in society to demand a bigger say in the national debate.
It's partly, you know, the Benedict bounce, the effect of the papal visit. And one of the things I think the church is going to be saying is, look, you know, if you want a more vigorous civil society, well, what is the basis of that? Faith plays a huge role in that. And the corollary, therefore, of the big society is religious freedom. You need to allow people to express themselves, to witness to their beliefs, even when they might offend other people. You can't have the fruits without the roots.
6 months after the Pope's visit, the church says it's too soon to see any effect of the Benedict bounce, reversing dwindling congregations or sparse recruitment to the priesthood. Some observers claim the overdominance of clergy is another of the church's biggest problems, and that the visit did nothing to address it.
The only people that can make any decisions in the church are the clerics. And there is a clerical culture, which the Pope is part of, which he didn't really address, in a sense. We have to change that clerical culture. And I feel there's a real resistance to doing so.
One lasting legacy of Pope Benedict's visit was the beatification of the Victorian theologian Cardinal John Henry Newman, placing him just one step away from becoming a saint. In Newman, the Pope created a model to inspire Catholics to holiness and Britain to embrace its Christian heritage. Well,